In this video, we will be solving the following word problem. A hospital raises funds for research through its home lottery program, which sold out early this year with sales of $1,902,000. There were 20,000 tickets available for purchase at a price of $1 for $100 or $3 for $250. The marketing manager wants to know how many tickets were purchased under each option. So I encourage you to pause the video here and try this problem out. If you are feeling overwhelmed by reading the question, you can start by organizing the information in a diagram by thinking about what's the whole and what are the parts. It's very important we think about the units that we're dealing with, whether it be dollars, number of tickets, etc. Let's start with the number of tickets. In total, 20,000 tickets were sold. This comprises of tickets from the single ticket option and from the three-pack option. So to find this, we need to know how many of each option was sold. Similarly, in total, they raised $1,902,000. That total comprises of all the money from the single ticket purchases and all the money from the three-pack purchases. And we can't know those dollar amounts contributed without knowing how many of each option was sold. Now let's use what we gathered through the diagrams to create our algebraic equations. We have identified that the unknowns we need to solve for are the number of each ticket option sold. Unknowns are assigned variables, and this should be explicitly stated at the start of the problem so anyone reading your solution will be able to understand what's happening. In our example, let x be the number of single ticket purchases, and we'll let y be the number of three-pack purchases. So let's look at using those variables in our equations. So if we consider first off the number of tickets, we know that there's a total of 20,000 tickets that were sold. And that'll comprise of all the single ticket purchases, which will contribute one ticket per purchase, plus all of the three-pack purchases. So each of those purchases will contribute to three tickets. There are many positive integer solutions that could satisfy this equation, so we need more information to get a single solution. We'll also have to generate an equation for the amount of money in sales. The total amount of sales was $1,902,000, and that was obtained by $100 for every single ticket purchase, so 100 times x. And $250 for every three-pack purchase, so 250 times y. So now what we have is a system of linear equations. Substitution and elimination are both useful strategies for solving such systems. Pause the video here and try solving this system on your own. Use whichever approach you find more efficient. There's lots of flexibility here in solving these questions. Whether you decided to use elimination by multiplying the first equation by negative 100, or substitution and isolating for x, there are many ways we could have tackled this problem. I'm going to approach this using substitution, as that first equation that x will be relatively simple for us to solve for. We'll begin by isolating for x in that first equation. We can do that by subtracting 3y from both sides of the equation. Then we can proceed by substituting this into our other equation. Then distribute the 100. And now we can group our like terms together and isolate for y. So all that remains in terms of solving this system is to substitute this y equals 1,960 into our equation to find x. And here we get x is equal to 14,120. Graphically, what we just found was the intersection of two lines. This is where those two equations shared the same x and the same y value. The other possibilities that could happen with a system of equations include no solution. So what that would look like graphically is the lines are parallel, they never cross. And we can also get infinitely many solutions where the lines would overlap entirely. Now we may have solved for x and y, but let's talk about what it is that we just found, and let's make sure we're answering the question that was asked. So the value of y that we found is actually the number of three packs that were purchased. And what we found for x was the number of single tickets purchased. So what the question was asking originally was, we want to know how many tickets were purchased under each option. So we have that 14,120 of the tickets sold were from single ticket purchases. And 3 times 1,960, or 5,880 of the tickets were sold from the 3-pack purchases. So now we've answered the question that was asked, how many tickets were purchased under each option? 14,120 tickets were sold under that single ticket or one for $100 option. And 5,880 tickets were sold under the 3 for $250 option.